Sad news to report, the balcony is now closed.
The World According to Jon.
Hello and welcome to The World According to Jon. My name is, as you know, Jonathan Paula. The unfortunate news today being reported by the Chicago Sun-Times, famed film critic Roger Ebert died today following complications of cancer at the age of 70. Now, I like to fancy myself a film critic. I've been doing my movie night program here on YouTube for the last 4 years, and I was reviewing films long before even then. And Siskel and Ebert's At the Movies, their syndicated talk show, where they spoke about the movies honestly, frankly, and enthusiastically for 30 years, is a huge inspiration in what I do for a living. And everything that Roger wrote and said has definitely permeated my career and my lifestyle as a film critic, as a film watcher, and just as an entertainer. He was a very smart, outspoken, and inspired millions in the process. And I am fortunate to count myself as one of those millions. And I learned a lot from him. So this news today was surprising to say the very least, considering just yesterday it was reported that he was going to take a leave of presence and scale back on his reviews because the cancer treatment was getting a little bit too much and he was getting sicker. So this is sudden and tragic news that I think all of us are giving two thumbs down to. He once famously remarked that no good film is too long and no bad movie is short enough. He was a film critic for the Chicago Sun-Times for 46 years, the first ever to win the Pulitzer in 1976, and a constant and consistent voice within the film community. And while I didn't always agree with his conclusions, I always applauded his ability to be so enthusiastic in his writing style. It was truly admirable. Whether he was talking about politics or film reviews, he would draw you in to his world, to his emotions, and you'd be able to connect with him. And I think everyone, at one point or another, was able to connect with Roger's work. And I think that is probably his most telling legacy. But even when his cancer worsened in 2006 and he had to physically remove his jaw to stay alive, he didn't stop reviewing films. He didn't stop blogging or tweeting. He was actually scheduling his cancer surgeries around the releases of major pictures because he loved the movies that much. And that's what we all loved about Roger. So after hearing of his tragic passing earlier today, I spent most of the afternoon on Twitter just clicking links, reading articles, looking at obituaries, watching videos, and reading some of his old film criticism, just to kind of reimmerse myself in Roger's life and his work. Even President Obama remarked that the movies won't be the same without Roger. But two articles really resonated with me today, so I will link to those below. One, an article by Roger himself a few years back dealing with death and what he thinks about it, and an obituary by the Chicago Sun-Times that really encapsulates everything that this guy stood for. So he will definitely be missed in this household because I looked up to him as a role model. He was an inspiration for what I do for a living. And just as a fan of film, we lost one of the greats today. He tweeted just yesterday a lengthy article about his leave of presence, ending with his final written words. So on this day of reflection, I say again, thank you for going on this journey with me. I'll see you at the movies. We certainly hope so, Roger. Thanks. Please let me know what you think about this story in the comments down below. But unfortunately, for now, that is The World According to Me. My name is John. Thank you for watching and listening. I hope to see you right back here in the very near future.